This is Mike from MPCstuff.com. Right now we're gonna show you how to install a new backlight for your MPC3000. If your backlight's getting dull, this is what you're gonna have to replace. So first things first, I'm gonna show you how to open up the unit. The MPC3000, this is gonna show you how to open it, and this can help you do a lot of things like the buttons, the pads, and all that as well. But right now we're gonna focus on the LCD. First, you're gonna take out, there's four screws. I've already taken mine out. There, 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 and there. So you're gonna pull those out first and then turn the unit on its other side. Now that we have the unit on the back, you're gonna see there's a screw here, 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 there, 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 and there. So they kind of fall around the edge. Once you have those out, you'll be able to open up the MPC. Now you can see I can open up the unit. Careful not to mess anything up on the inside. And what we're looking for is right here, which is the housing for our LCD screen. Other things you'll notice, if you need to replace any buttons or anything, that's gonna have to be this board that comes up here. Along with this one over here, it has some buttons in it as well. Up here, we have the power supply and some other things. Right here are the OS chips that you can change out. There's the drive. The pads are located underneath this plate here, so if you need to change the pads out, you need to remove the three screws around there along with that plate, and you'll be able to access the pads and then the pad sensors. Okay, now I've gone ahead and I've tilted this upwards kind of out of the way here so I can work on the area where the LCD is. This coming from here, that came will probably come out of the board when you flip it up, so just remember it goes right there. Try to keep everything else connected, that way you don't have to worry about it. I've taken my four screws that hold the LCD surround in, and we're gonna go ahead and pull this up so we can start working on this. Now on each side of the LCD, you're gonna see two screws on each side. I've taken mine out here, that way I can get this out. You'll see there's two other ones here on the other side that we need to remove. All right, and as you can see, I've taken the little brackets off. And they have these little, right here, washers along with the back brackets when you pull them off the side of your LCD here. So you're gonna pull those out so you can get this away from here so you can access the screws that are on the top, on the back of here. So we're gonna pull these four screws out now and pull the back plate off the LCD cover. Now that I've popped the cover off, I have access to LCD itself. Now we're gonna work on putting in the new backlight. Okay, now there's four screws that go around the actual LCD here and here, and now we'll be able to, once we get those screws out, we'll be able to pull the LCD out. Once we get this out, you're gonna see on the inside here is where the backlight is being hidden. You can see right here, this one's actually been replaced before at some point. Sorry about the focus. Right there, we need to get that one out. And you can see it has two little posts that are going and are soldered onto the back side right here. So that's where the backlight is on the inside. You can see right there with those two things. Now we're gonna get that one out and we're gonna put our new one in. Our new one bypasses this, so we're gonna actually use this cord here and it's gonna be a direct plug and play. But let me get this old one out. We're just gonna pull it out and I'll show you how that works. Okay, I used tweezers to pull mine out to get it started, and I had to cut the tabs that were coming out. I had to cut those, that way this will come out. Now that I have this out, I'm gonna get our new one, and we're gonna install that. All right, so here's our new backlight here, and you can see it comes with the tail. We're gonna go ahead and put this in just like the old one was, with the pink side up. So we're gonna go ahead and slide it in just like that, and we'll have this tail here, and then I'll show you what we're gonna do with the tail. As you can see, the way our new one fits, it actually has notches here and here for the screws to go back in when you put it back on. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna show you on the back side. Like I said, we cut off the other connections, the other connector. So right now we have this wire here that was the original supply for the backlight, and that's gonna be replaced with this new one. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna get this back in, we're gonna fish this wire back through to replace this one here. And as you know, the old one kind of goes up here, around here, and then goes up here to where it's powered. This is gonna come out completely, and we're gonna end up taking our new backlight and using this connector to put in there instead. And we're just gonna get rid of this wire. You can see it comes with zip ties, so you're gonna have to cut some of these zip ties off to get this wire loose, but it has new zip ties so you can install those. So we're gonna go ahead and put this back into the LCD housing, fish the black wire through it, and then get that going there. All right, as you can see now, we've got all four of our screws back in. And again, we have this one cut off, we're gonna get rid of this, and this is gonna take place through the hole. So we're gonna have to, when we put this back together here, this is gonna have to go and follow out when we put our back case back on here. It's gotta follow out right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you that, and then we're gonna go ahead and show you how to route the cable to the controller. All right, now as you can see, we have everything, we have our LCD housing back together, and we put it back on here, and I have out through the bottom, have fished the black wire out through. What a lot of people do, I'm not gonna do it in this case, but a lot of people just end up cutting this off here, that way you don't have to undo all everything on the way. Just cut it off, tape off the ends, and then over here, you have the same thing. You can just cut it off since it won't be used on either side. It's not that big of a deal to have it in here because it's secure and there's nothing going through it once you've unhooked it and you're not using that anymore. And now we'll be using black wire instead. So I'm gonna go ahead now and put that in. First, I'm sorry, I'm gonna do the side pieces here and put this back in for the tilt, and then I'll show you the next step. Okay, now that that's secured and I have the LCD back in and the tilt assembly all assembled back together, we're kind of back at the beginning again where we have our four screws here, and now you'll be able to easier see where our new black wire is coming out. And here's the old wire, like I said, that we can just snip off, or if you want to actually remove it completely, you have to get it out of these looms here. We do include the zip ties, so you can take this wire and zip tie it along with these to follow up to here, where we're gonna install this connector where this one used to be. All right, as you can see now, I've routed the black one up and over and in. You'll notice the connector now is a little bit different. That connector, it's okay, it can go in either way, so it doesn't really matter. You'll see the old white connector is different, but this one can go either way, so there's not, no big deal here. Try to make sure your wire here isn't anywhere in these components here, down here or down here. So as you can see, mine's routed straight through here. I added an extra zip tie there, and you can see where I installed the zip ties and took the old wire out. Like I said, if you want, you can cut the old wire out and just keep it there and then zip tie the other ones on top so you don't have to redo every single one, but this is the more proper way to do it. So now that we've done that, we're gonna put our four screws back into here and around here. We're gonna plug this back in right up there, and we're gonna shut our unit and test it out. All right, now that we've put the cover back over, we're gonna go and put our screws back in the bottom, the eight screws around the edges. Then we're gonna go ahead and put the four back in the top here, and we're gonna test our unit. Now, as you can see, we got everything back together, and now our LCD screen now lights up, as before it was completely dull and you couldn't see anything. So that's how you install the backlight on an MPC3000. Keep in mind, the instructions that we gave with this video are quite quick, so we understand if you might have issues. There's also written directions that come with these kits from MPCstuff.com, so you'll be able to use the written directions as well if you need to.